What's good, what's up, and welcome back to my channel. You
wanna do the cupping with me?
Yeah.
Okay, so it goes like this. Do you know how to do that? Yeah, like that. We'll do it 3 times.
Okay.
Ready? 8. 8.
Imagine I think I was off beat.
Hello guys, what's up? What's good? Here with Miss Maravot, my friend. Introduce yourself.
My name is Maravot. Like she said, I'm her friend. Do we say like how we met and stuff, or
it's not that type of video? It's not that type of video. She's not my boyfriend, guys. Sorry.
Today I brought her on because we're gonna do a fun little video today. I'm super excited. Last night we posted on our Instagram stories and we asked people to send us toxic things that they have done or that's happened to them, and we got a lot of we got a lot of responses, and we're so excited to get into it. We're gonna keep their identities anonymous, so y'all don't need to worry about that.
Anyways, yeah, mind your business.
Period. Let's get right into the video.
Period.
Okay, yo, I got a bunch. You guys like sent a bunch. Okay, wait, okay, this is the first one. It says, got cheated on and beat him the fuck up. Whole time I was cheating and he never knew.
It's the fact that she beat him the fuck up.
It's the fact that she beat him the
knowing damn well she was cheating too.
That's kind of sick.
Imagine.
Like, we shouldn't be the last.
Imagine fucking a nigga up.
And the whole time you were wrong.
You know what?
Girl, that was a lot.
I traveled 20 plus hours to get asked for a divorce.
Two zero. At this point, just send me a text. No, seriously. I'd rather you send me a text instead of you make me drive 20 hours for you to tell me we're not together anymore, nigga. Are you dumb? Are you bro?
I'm so sorry, honey, that happened to you. That is the most disrespectful thing I...
That you deserve to get your ass beat.
Divorce?
That you deserve to get,
like,
yes.
You know, no, getting dumped is different. But divorce?
I would beat him up. There's no way he's coming
out. Up.
He used my Netflix account while effing another girl. That's so rude. What is wrong with y'all?
How do you know, though?
Ooh, that's a good question. Imagine he sent her, like, a snap of them, like, watching...
How'd you find that out?
Yeah.
Because that's disrespectful. I'd be pissed. Cheated on by every girlfriend except one.
Wait, how many girlfriends did he have? Boys be having one girlfriend and then they're just dicks for the rest of their life. They just have one bad experience and they're just assholes for the rest of their lives.
I don't know. I feel like it's a good question though. How many girls, to be honest?
Exactly. Because if it's one girl,
fuck
all
you.
Right. Grow up.
Not fuck you. That was so out of pocket. I apologize. That was not cool. Sorry.
My ex didn't talk to me for 3 days because our friend played a song about cheating and I didn't tell.
Wait, what? Can you say that again?
wait.
No, repeat that.
Ex. My ex didn't talk to me for 3 days because our friend played a song about cheating and I didn't tell. Like, she didn't tell him.
To turn it
that,
like off?
That it was a song about cheating.
And he didn't talk to her for 3 days. The question is, did you get back together with him after that?
Wait, I've never heard some foolery like this.
3 days? Imagine your boyfriend saying, you know what, fuck
even
you.
One day, even 1 hour, bro, why are you mad that I listened to a song? You're mad that I listened to a song about cheating? Grow up. Wait, no, hold on. The full response is, didn't talk to him. Our friend played a song about cheating and I didn't tell her to turn it off. like he's mad that he didn't tell her like, hey, turn off that song because it's about cheating.
Imagine this. You're in a car. A song comes on, it's a cheating song. Take a bow comes on.
Yeah. I'm lonely, I'm sorry, because you're not. And maybe you're lonely, lonely,
sorry, yeah, come on. And the whole time, your man is in the backseat boiling.
She said, I'm talking to her, this person when I
come. No, it's your mind and your business. You're like, and he didn't talk to you for 3 days. And he thinks that's normal.
You're sick. Did you break up with him? Let me know if you broke up with him.
Was he cheating?
Let me know if you broke up with him. Because if you didn't break up with him...
She did. It's his ex. Her ex.
No, how long after that?
It's the question. Told me that my dead nephew would be ashamed of me. That's not funny, like, at all. Like, it's not funny. So fucked up.
That's not funny.
No, I'm just awkward. Sometimes I like in situations.
Wait. I need to even read it again.
That's not funny.
I'm dead. Just like
him.
You can't do that.
That was so good.
Anyways.
I greened out on his dick and didn't tell him because, oh, slobbery.
What is happening?
What is wrong with y'all? Seriously. That's the real question. Because what? Out of pocket.
Oh, girl, this was a continuation. Like, I greened out on his dick and didn't tell him because, oh, slobbery. But when he went on that night and cheated on me, she sucked my puke off that dirty dick.
That's crazy. That's karma. That's really karma. I hope you're okay. I hope you learned from your greening out experience. But I'm glad that
you got your suck for me part.
Like, I like how you kept it going, but that... Could you... First of all, he said, I'm gonna go cheat on her that night. And now, the girl that you're cheating thinks you have a dirty dick. She said, sour dick. That's disgusting. You took it out.
Yikes. Simped for a boy that was dusty, crusty, smelly, and broke. God, please keep them away.
I think we've all went through that.
Shell.
That was a phase you shouldn't go through, but I went through
it. It's not even a phase. At this point, it's a lifestyle.
Okay.
Because have you seen the men out there? Yuck.
My partner told me he would kill himself if I left.
Do it. No, because why are you threatening someone that you're gonna kill yourself? Go.
That's low. That's the most manipulative. Well, that's one of the most manipulative things you can do to someone.
Are you sick? If I don't kill you myself,
I want to roll tonight.
Not telling me he had a whole wife? Yo.
Honestly, we've been there before.
Yo, when I tell you men are just.
We've all been there before, right?
Garbage. How do you cheat on your wife, bro? It's not even your girlfriend.
Apparently easy.
That's just next level.
He woke up and he said,
oh, I'm not feeling it today.
That's nuts.
I feel like if you cheat, you're just a very selfish person.
Period.
Do better. X-Men told me to send him a sexy pic and then body shame him. No, it's not funny.
No. No. Wait. Is there more? No. X-Man told me to send him a sexy pic and then body shame me and sent me workout videos.
It's not funny. That is the most disrespectful thing you could ever do.
I would jump.
Y'all are really going through it.
Oh my gosh. A whole workout video.
He said, ew, here's some Chloe Ting video. That's so messed up. That's so messed up.
Girl, you are beautiful. Fuck him.
Because what?
I dare. Actually, I know.
You should have. You should have sent him a video threatening him. A video with you holding a knife.
Tell me to lose weight again, bitch.
X gave me an expensive birthday gift after he cheated on me and I left him. As you should. But X gave me an expensive birthday gift after he cheated on me. Guys love to overcompensate when they're doing something wrong.
Yeah, I totally agree. But was the gift nice though?
That's honestly what matters.
Yeah, because if it was, then it's like, okay, it's a good parting. Thank you.
Because guess what? This guy was doo-doo anyways.
Yeah, and if it was really expensive, sell it.
Period.
Yeah.
Get your money, sis.
Get your coins.
Get it.
Reimburse yourself. And that's on?
Period. My boyfriend and I broke up, and he texted me a day later saying he lost his V card. The next day?
Some people are just like that. It's not okay.
He said, I need to get rid of this. That's so rude. Why would you text me that information? Imagine a guy breaking up with you, and then the next day he's like, hey girl, just checking up on you, by the way. Virgin, not me. Nuts. You're nuts for doing that.
Yeah, you're a dick. Man's was going through my phone during sex, got mad I was seeing other people.
You played it yourself. Because you in my business?
Don't do that. That's so funny.
You played yourself.
Why are you going like through your phone during sex?
During intercourse.
That's weird. That was your first mistake.
That was your fault. You played yourself.
And now you guys are both mad.
Yeah. I would act super uninterested whenever they sounded really excited about something.
Oh, that's a little rough. You're sick.
She'd be like,
wow, that's cool. That's crazy.
You won the lottery?
Wow.
Oh.
Okay.
She doesn't care. I completely ghosted someone without any type of explanation or communication.
Don't we all do that though?
You don't need to do that. All that extra stuff, you don't even need to. Explanation for who?
Why? Why? It's been a month. It's been 2 weeks. Even if it's been 3 months. Is there a ring on my finger?
No.
Sorry.
You paid my bills?
You my business.
Don't do that.
I cheated instead of leaving someone. I still regret that to this day. It makes me feel sick. Aww. At least you reflect.
F you. No. F you from the past. Like, F your past. But if you're better now, I'm happy that you're better now.
Yeah, me too.
And I'm happy that, like, you know, you took accountability. Yeah. Because a lot of people don't take accountability.
Yeah, they just keep doing it.
Yeah. But it's okay, girl. Everybody makes mistakes. Your mistakes it was just a little big, but it's fine. It was still a mistake. And guess what?
Everybody has those days.
Yeah. Wait, it already looks crazy.
Okay.
Are you ready? I need you to hear this, because the first four words are already nuts.
Okay.
I paid a $180 Uber to see him, and he told me I couldn't stay. Found out later, he brought another girl over.
I'm so sorry.
$180?
That's groceries.
Canadian dollars?
That's a phone bill. That's clothes.
That is what's getting you beat up. I dare somebody
hold
to send
up,
me.
Hold up. So does that mean she paid $180 back?
Are Are you not embarrassed?
This is really embarrassing.
You're so mean.
I'm sorry.
If I pay $180, that's a vacation. I'm staying there for a week.
Yeah. I paid $187 to stay at a hotel for 2 days.
And you were in the car for an hour.
I hope you cussed him out at least.
I hope you did something.
I hope you stood up for yourself.
Revenge. Something.
Some sort of something.
Because that is norms.
He said wouldn't tell girls he was getting nudes from that he has a girlfriend because it was rude.
Wait, what? Because it's rude?
It's rude.
It's rude. I'm sorry.
And you don't want to say no because it's rude.
So when did you drop him? I want to know how soon after that did you drop him.
You know what's fucking rude? That's so... Could you... He don't like you. He wanted to see those moves.
She said, bitch, sit up.
She said, cheated on my birthday and then pushed him down the stairs from getting mad at him for it.
Wait. I want to read it again. No, she got pushed down the stairs.
Oh, she got pushed?
She got pushed.
No, but she said cheated on him on my birthday.
And
then pushed down the stairs from getting mad at him for it.
Yeah. Like, he pushed her because he was mad that she was mad about it.
That he cheated on her?
Yes.
And he pushed her down the stairs.
What type of men do y'all know? Where have y'all met these people? I had an ex that couldn't stay out of jail or keep a job, and I stayed with him for 3 years.
I don't even... I'm trying to...
3 years, dog? I would have left
after a year. Is there more to it? Yeah, there is. He would gaslight me constantly. I still have problems trusting my own intuition.
That's so sad.
In those moments, I feel my heart goes out to you because that might be like a very scary situation.
Yeah.
Like, not wanting to, like, not being able to leave.
Yeah, just because you feel like you're scared of the outcome.
So, I'm sorry to go through that.
This is a long one. Let me bring out my reading voice. I spanked her ass mid argument out of frustration after she swinged at me a bunch. I just grabbed her arms and held her tight so she couldn't swing. And then few spanks on her ass out of aggression. And it's the one and only time I struck a girl besides my sis when we were kids. And it still bothers me. We stayed together like 6 months after that. I finally grabbed all of my stuff and dipped while she was at work the day after she putted a cig out on my face mid-argument.
What did I just read?
What in the BDSM is going on here?
Shut up, bitch.
Guys hit a wall and a girl panics and labels him a BPD patient but will wail fist down during arguments like it's nothing.
I don't know how to respond to that.
She putted a cig out on his face. Mid argument?
Could you imagine? No, it's like, that's so delicious, like, mid argument, like, you're fighting.
She said,
no, she said, the whole conversation, she's not taking you seriously, she's smoking.
She said, where am I gonna put out this? She said,
not even that, she's like,
he better not say another word before, he said, he better not. Imagine going to the hospital and explaining your burn.
It's the fact that she sat there and she just said, like, you know, like, I've had impulsive things that I've done that.
That's funny.
But she really said, fuck your face, fuck you, fuck everything. Let people blame my health for reasons they didn't invite me, not completely understanding something, and then turn hurt their feelings, neglected them.
What did he say?
Oh, I get what she's saying. Because she has health problems,
mm-hmm.
and like it's not her fault, mm-hmm. but I'm pretty, like, her friends would use to like not invite her to things
because of it.
Yeah, just because, and it's like, it's not, her health wasn't like preventing her from doing those things.
Oh, okay.
They just didn't want her.
That's messed up.
Yeah.
Like, those are not your friends.
Those aren't good friends. And I hope you have better friends.
Yeah.
Cause that's not cool.
That's messed up. You're supposed to accept the people
for who they are.
You.
Yeah.
And if you don't like them, then why would they be friends with you?
Mm-hmm. Or like, just tell people from the beginning, like, you don't mess with them like that. Cause then
that's
not weird. Like,
that's messed up.
Then you're doing stuff like this to people that genuinely like are genuine and care.
Yeah.
He told my mom I had my titties pierced.
Wait, like that's your mom a secret? Like,
could you imagine getting your titties pierced and then telling your boyfriend and you guys break up and he tells your mom?
Out of spite.
And now you have to talk to your mom about it, like, it's out of spite.
That's messed up. Especially if you knew that she wasn't comfortable letting her mom know that information. Why would you do that just out of spite?
You literally
have some respect.
You crossed a boundary. Never complimented me, but would download Tinder and compliment every girl.
No. Y'all are out of pocket.
Mod.
Y'all are out of
pocket. Could you imagine going on your man's phone and going on, and you've been dating him for a year? He's never told you you look pretty. He's never said you look nice. He just thought you would know.
And this guy's out here giving free compliments
and
on the
Tinder
app.
He's like, oh my god, you're so beautiful. Oh my god, your body's so nice.
Get out of my face. Get out of my face. Out of my face.
I don't know if I'm gonna love you.
She said, you're so dramatic. She said, I think it's done. I think it's over.
I think love is fake. Shout out to you guys that, you know, like actually responded.
Yeah, that opened up to us and that sent us
some juicy stuff
and multiples. Shout out to the ones that sent multiple.
Yeah.
I'm sorry y'all been through it.
Should we say toxic things we've done?
That's another video.
And that's the end of the video, guys. Thank
Bye
you guys
bye.
So much for watching. Did y'all like this video?
I hope y'all enjoyed.
Did y'all like the tea? Did y'all like all of that?
Did you? I hope you did.
Let me know if you want to see another video like this. And let me know if you want to see another video with Miss Merv over here.
You will.
Make sure you follow her on Instagram. It's going to be right here. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on all my socials, Instagram at Queen Kadia, Twitter at Queen Kadia 2, and TikTok at Queen Kadia. Baby, okay, go get it. Twisted. And with that being said, I'll see you guys next week. Bye.